Thank you. Hello? I'm gonna turn my mic on because I can't. There's too many chat messages to respond to. Is there a way to move rack 8 and put it in patcher? Hold on, let me try something. What if I... this? I'm just thinking. Maybe if... No, that doesn't work. No, there's no way to do that. I don't think. I think FL or image line will have to add a feature like that or something. Laxcity. I rarely speak on these. I don't know. I don't talk much on my streams, but I feel like I'll have to because so many of you guys have questions. I remember someone asked to break down the instruments on the big swell section. I think you're talking about this part here. Yo, equal, what? I've had those kind of dreams before. They're fucking hilarious. Please work. Yo, I would gladly work with ImageLine for updates on things because there's so many things I wish they could add to FL. One thing they should, like, one thing I want them to add is so when you're in Edison and you record something, the only thing you have to send it quickly to the playlist is this button and dragging this onto a sampler. But there should be like a drop-down menu like you have in the sampler plugin where you can send it to a new sampler channel, granularizer, slicer, or SliceX. Basically, having this menu in here would be super useful. Better granularizer. The granularizer is good enough. I think it's pretty decent for whatever you need to do. Hey, see you later, Maxo. Good luck with the move to England. I hope you be comfortable. Just don't step outside and you will not be broke. That's all you got to do. All you've got to do. Portal's insane, but if you know what you're doing with the granularizer, you can do some pretty sick things with it. Icons so small because I have this big litter screen now. Got to say, it's really, really useful. Like, I can zoom out and my projects look kind of tiny, but in reality, they're actually big. Quite big. Full Adidas tracksuit. Gonna wear the puffer coat as well. Pick up the accent. Gonna start hanging around at off-license shops. You're gonna live in a council house, Zach. You know, the full package. I'd say I used a balanced amount of third-party and stock plugins, but most of the time I use stock plugins Because, yeah, I know them a lot better than third party plugins. Run your change for me, bruv. What are you saying? Water. I don't even know. I live in the UK. I don't even know why I don't have the accent. Just never picked it up. Yo, actually, don't blame me. Top Boy is a good fucking show. It's a really good show. I started with Top Boy and then Top Boy Summer House because I didn't know Summer House was the seasons before Top Boy. I haven't got the flow to be rapping. I don't think I would. I mean, I could give it a try. One, I haven't got lyrics. Two, I haven't got the flow for it. Three, there's just something about me making trap beats and not making it sound ghetto enough. I don't know what it is. Like, I can't, I can make trap music, but it won't sound as ghetto as, like, most trap music sounds. Do you know what I mean? Like, it'll sound like laxcity trap music. It won't sound like, all the ghetto poppy stuff. My PC specs. I think I have a... All I know is I have a Ryzen processor, 16 gigabytes of RAM, GTX 1080, a 1 terabyte SSD, a 3 terabyte hard drive. What else am I missing? Where is my VTuber? Oh man, I got rid of that a long time ago. I should bring him back. It was actually quite nice to have a motherfucking damn, I can't words line. And talk for shit. The funny thing is, I don't know my PC parts very well. I don't know if Ryzen is best you can get. My friend, who's a friend, Light Shadow, who's a big tech expert geek. He put my setup together for me, so I don't really know if the parts I have are good parts. All I know is this PC is working, and FL Studio runs really smoothly with it. Do you want me to show you the sauce? These layers, all the sauce. Got you, fam. I got you. All right. At the top, we have... Hold on. At the top here, we have... a piano thingy. Just a bunch of... Just playing these notes constantly. It's actually this... It's just that. I had a delay on it before I consolidated it, but that's this, I guess. I'm bad at explaining things, because it's not being... Then we have this swell thing here. That is a pad that I made a long time ago. The date on it. When I made it. It was quite a while ago. And then we have the the layer mixture of a Reese, a sound font. So we have this Reese and this sound font, which is a solo cello. excuse me. Bad. Fucking hay fever. Kicking my ass. I hate this. I hate this so much. Like, I took some Benadryl, and I still sneeze. I don't know what. Is it me? Like, anyone that has hay fever, like, vouch for me, saying hay fever is a lot worse this year than it's ever been before. So bad. Anyway, as I was saying, we have this cello sound font. Sup. So you guys can hear sound like. So yeah, we have this reed. Sounds like this, and then the cello, and then one of the default direct wave that's come with FL. With that, have this string section, just playing chords, no bass. You know, just some top end content to guide the flow of the chorus. Then we have a couple of pulse stretched things over here, I think. Serving as a pad. Actually, I should to the mixer track, so. And also EQ it. I need to mix this down, actually. Yeah, Frasco, I have a Discord server. It's, right here. Although it's not active, I will warn you. Like, not a lot of us talk in there, and, when we do talk, it's mostly just shitposting. So, just a fair warning before you join. Next, we have... I forget what this is. Oh yeah, this is some samples from that film Philharmonia sample pack that I have that are just being triggered by MIDI, the right notes, with a ton of reverb on them, and next we have another pulse stretched thing. Which is like the meat of this chorus, the meat of these layers, carrying everything else again. And we also have these, which are my voice. Actually, I won't play that, but this sounds like this. Just some vocal pads. And then we have this. Another vocal pad. I've been making music for like 7 to 8 years now. Yeah, it should be at least 8 or 7 now. If I check my mixes in mono, I've heard of that way of mixing, but honestly, over the years, I've just developed ability to tell that something's going to sound good Actually, no. I still struggle with that. I don't get the mixing in mono thing. But I think it's useful for making sure that anything you play it on anything, it's gonna sound good. But I've just been trusting my ears and my methods for years, so I don't think that's gonna change at all. Then we have this. Which is a bunch of flutes that I put together. So it's just, I just take these, put some reverb on them, and just play any notes that harmonize with the rest of the song. Next we got another Paul Stretch thing. Is this. And then we have me singing. So I'm running these through some EQ and a patcher. Got Fruity Convolver on a blur preset. Which is like, it's almost close to Valhalla Room reverb, but it's like a cheap version of that, and it sounds really good. And I'm EQing that reverb at the same time. Then some more Paul Stretch stuff. Actually, this is some Folly that I blurred in Edison. If anyone doesn't know what that is, it's basically do this, and you press Control B, and it becomes this reverbed thing. I just turned some fuller recording of some water into that, just to add some, just a bed, white noise, to help out with the rest of the Paul Stretch stuff. As you can tell, like, some of the pulse-stretched elements in this track have no high end, so this is just filling up all of that. And also, I just like adding white noise to stuff, because it just makes things sound cleaner. I don't know what it is. It's just a habit I've picked up recently. We also have this. Another flute. I think I sampled this on YouTube. and then this is some, this is the sound of a guy I found on Fiverr who was recording a bunch of yellow stuff for me that I never used. I just sampled that as well. This flute, I don't remember where it's from. I think it's, it might be that. Oh no, it's a flute. I do see what you mean when you say it sounds like an owl, but it's a flute. I think it was this one. Yeah, it was probably from that audio clip. And then last but not least, we have this, more Paul Stretch stuff. I'm just automating the volume at crucial points where everything just becomes louder in volume and then quietens down, because that just adds a bit more etherealness to the chorus. And I don't know, that's I think that's everything. I've gone through every layer that I've forgotten what this sounds like. Let me play this from start to finish and just see where we're at. See, the thing is, I don't want it to end there. I kind of just want to do a thing with drums in it. But I don't know if my mental health can take that. This took very is this it took really, really long to strike. That's an accurate scene that this track paints. I just want to put like chords here or something. Value wasp been using quite a lot lately. Wasp kind of sucks, but like just bear with me on. Another one of this is Wasp. It's a FL native plugin that only runs on 32-bit. Yes, I'm using 32-bit FL, not 64. I don't know what it is, but I just can't make good music on 64-bit FL. I don't know why that is. I guess the difference between 32-bit and 64 is just more memory, and you can use 64-bit plugins without any problems. I remember I used to have this problem with OTT, where if I ran it on the 32-bit version of FL, I would not be able to tweak the knobs for some reason. The same would happen with Vital. So yeah, if you use 32-bit FL and you load a third-party plugin that's working on 64-bit, it's just gonna mess everything up. So don't do that. Don't do that. Let me just jam around for a little bit here. Not recording. Okay, I think that'll be good enough. Okay, these are not on grid. Just realized. Because this guitar sample is not even in time. But it still has an interesting melody. Thank you. Yeah, I don't have crystallizer though. That would be sick. That would be sick though. Alright, I think that's just gonna end there. Unfortunately, this doesn't mean that I've reached the 3-minute mark, because there's still this much space, so I don't really know how long the song actually is. Kinda sucks. I resampled an old song that I did, that I made. Thank you so much, guys. And Liquid Lou, I appreciate you using my sample pack in your songs. That means a lot. I hope you are ready for the next pack, because I've been working on that one for a long, long time. I'll admit, I've been procrastinating on it, but it's turning out really nicely because I've been procrastinating. If that makes sense. Yo, Sebjin, I'm trying, bro. I'm the kind of person who, if I don't procrastinate, I don't get things done. It's a weird combination, but it kind of works. The Ulusoul remix has been released. You can just listen to that in your own time. Go. That's the same remix you're asking about. That last part sounds cool to sample. Yeah, basically, I'm just sampling clips that I'll never finish. I often find that that's a good way to progress with a song. Like, it might sound like a mess, but you could probably, like, fit it in somehow. Like, if you do that more often, like, sample your old stuff, you will come out with unique sounds, because it's your own thing. So I highly encourage that people do that. I'd really like to get a vocalist for this track. I'd like to find someone who sounds like a combination between Imogen Heap and maybe Billie Eilish, just to sing the softer parts. That would be cool. That would be really sick. Because I don't think this track needs a male vocalist. I think this is a female vocalist material. Still need to add some stuff in between that in that outro. This sounds done. About 90% done, just with some more. That, the cover of the From the Heart Project. Yeah, I actually contributed to some of those songs on From the Heart. But I'm not really sure where that project stands, because there's been some drama behind that project, but whatever, that's in the past. Maybach music. So I'm trying to get back into streaming. I want to do more of these and maybe bring back feedback streams and just little beat contests or whatever. Like, no, not beat contests, beat challenges. I want to bring those back at some point. Next time you see me streaming, hopefully I'll have like the full webcam thingy set up and we can get back into what I used to do when I lived in Bristol. That was fun. Just always had problems with speaking all the time, and yeah, just streaming is like public speaking, and I'm not really the kind of person that likes to talk for ages, but hopefully I can ease my way back into more regular streams. Oh damn, I wish I was going to this guy. But it's hard to tell how traveling will be after. Well, it's hard to tell how traveling will be in a few months. Yeah, Yen Yenu I just saw the notification for you. Appreciate you copying some merch. That means a lot. Like, it's weird to see my music in the form of a physical object that you can wear. Just something about it. Like, that's just to see that that's something that I've made and put out there is just like, what? Insane. But yeah, thanks for popping some merch, man. I appreciate it. Appreciate you. I love all of y'all. Thank you for just supporting me in general. A lot. Right. I'ma get off now. Let's see who we can raid. If you know someone underrated who does music that we can raid right now. Bro. Oh wait, Omniboy streaming. Let's raid Omniboy.
I would say America's not the
right, let me do this. Go. Right. I'll see you guys next time whenever I stream. All right. Peace out. Love y'all.
Me too, actually, Bree. I do not go near the beach. LOL. It's very extreme. Yeah, what the heck? It was wild.
Okay, I don't want anybody to panic.
Wait.
But we appear to be receiving a Twitch raid. Everybody just remain calm.
Run! It's a
Twitch raid! 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 A Twitch raid!
Thank you so much, laxcity, for the Twitch. For the Twitch, I really appreciate it. I didn't even know you were live right now.